Hi everybody, 11 Institute welcomes all the students of Standard 10 to Mathematics Chapter Number 5, Video Lecture Number 9. In the previous video lecture, you had been given the homework of Exercise 5.3, Main Question Number 1 and Main Question Number 2. Let us first quickly go through the solution of this and then we shall move ahead with the Exercise 5.3. Yes. So this is exercise 5.3 and this is question number 1 where you have to find the sum. So each and everywhere arithmetic progression is given, so you can definitely have the value of A and D everywhere, right? There is no issue with it. Apart from that, you also have been given the value of N, that you have to find sum up to N terms, up to 12 terms and up to 11 terms and up to 100 terms. So you have to just apply the formula, that's it. So you can see the formula of SN is applied everywhere. You can go through the steps, compare these steps with the answers that you have got, and in case you have made any mistake, you can rectify it at your own end. Right, so this is the solution for sub question number 1 and sub question number 2. Now let us see the solution for number 3. Yes, so this is the solution for number 3. This is the value of A, value of D, N is equal to 100, and all you have done is just applied the formula of SN, right? And you have the answer 5505. Please check with the homework that you have done. Next is number 4. Yes, and this is bit tough if you are not handy with the calculations, although we cannot say that this is tough, but still let us discuss that here we have A is equal to 1 by 15, N is equal to 11, and D is equal to second term minus first term. So this is 1 upon 12 minus 1 upon 15. Now I will explain it over here. See, 1 upon 12 minus 1 upon 15, right? Yes, so now when we cross multiply this, we get 15 ones are 15. Minus 12 ones are 12, whole divided by 12 into 15. So 15 minus 12 is 3, divided by 12 into 15. So 3 gets over cancelled over here 4 times, and 15 fours are 60, so we get 1 upon 60 like this. Right, I hope this is clear to you. Then you have to just apply the formula, that's it. That also I will explain to you. Let me create some space over here. In case you have any doubt, you can rewind and see this again, how we obtained the value of D. Yes, and now let us see how the formula of SN is applied. So SN is N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Put up all the values and finally you have this 2 upon 15 plus 10 upon 60, or 2 upon 15 plus 1 by 6. So I will show you how to solve this. 2 upon 2 upon 15 plus 1 upon 6. So here we have 2 upon 15 plus 1 upon 6. So again 6 2s are 12 plus 15 1s are 15 divided by 15 into 6. So 12 plus 15 is nothing but 27 divided by 15 into 6. Now you very well know that 3 9s are, right, and 3 2s are. Again 3 3s are and 3 5s are. So what we have is 3 upon 10 after solving this much. 3 upon 10. Here see, you have 9 upon 30. So 9 upon 30 ultimately 3 3s are and 3 10s are, it means 3 upon 10 only, right? And then when you multiply by 11 upon 2, right, you get 33 upon 20, that's it. So the sum of 11 terms is 31 upon 20, nothing else. I hope this is very much clear to you and you don't have any doubts, right? So let us erase this. You can tally this with the homework that you have done. In case you have any doubts, you can rectify this, you can re-watch those particular minutes of video lecture again, right? So this was about question number 1. Now let us see question number 2. Here, so here what you have been given is AP along with the last term, Right, so let me explain this. See, let me change the color so that icon is visible to you. Yeah. So this is the AP. So this is the first term. A is equal to 7. Sorry. Have the eraser over here. Okay, so we don't erase this. There is some problem. Very sorry, I am unable to erase this, but understand, here we have the value of A, that is 7. We have the last term 84. We can find the common difference from over here, right? Now what you want to do is you want to find the sum of this. So when you want to find the sum, you will definitely apply the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus l, or a plus an, first term plus last term. Now you have the value of first term, you have the value of last term, but you don't have the value of n. So in order to find the value of n, you will apply the formula of an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Here you will put the value of a, put the value of an, put the value of n. You can see over here, that is done over here. Right, we have used the formula last term is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. By putting up all the values, we get the value of n. Once we get the value of n, we just have to put in this formula. I hope this is very much clear to you. Fine, let us see the second one. See, again, in the second one, right, you have this, just a minute. Yes, so now we are having a clear picture over here. So we have the value of A as 34, which is our first term. Then we can find the common difference, which is minus 2. And you have the last term 10. So again, you will apply the formula of last term over here. You can see we have applied the formula of last term over here. Input all the values and we will get the value of n over here. So we get n is equal to 13. Once you get the value of n, you just have to apply this formula. Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus l. Fine. Once you do this, what happens? You have to put the value of n, a, and the last term, and you get the answer 286. Similarly, we have done in the third one also. Alright, apply the formula of last term, get the value of n, and then put in this formula. So you can check the answers, and in case you have made any mistakes, you can rectify it. Right. So this both were given to you in homework. Now let us move to today's topic. Let us start with question number 3. Yes. Fine. So example number 16 was left. So let us start with example number 16. So we will write solution over here. This is red color actually. Might not be visible to you. Let us change the color of pen first. Yes. So we will input the solution over here. Yes, a manufacturer of TV sets produced 600 sets in the third year, right? So a TV manufacturer is producing some TVs in the first year, second year, third year, fourth year. So we have been told that in the third year, the manufacturer produced 600 sets, right? So we will highlight that. And now let us consider that this is a particular term in arithmetic progression, right? So first of all, we will write over here the production, the TV production actually each year, the TV production each year forms an arithmetic progression, forms an arithmetic progression. So based upon that, we can write number of TVs produced in third year, right? Number of TV sets produced in third year. So that will be our third term. We will notify that as A3. So A3 will become 600 for us. Right. Similarly, when we read ahead, it is written that 700 sets in the 7th year. 700 sets in the 7th year. So we will again write over here number of TV sets produced in 7th year. Is equal to A7, and what is the value of A7? It is 700. You can see 600 sets in third year, so A3 is equal to 600. 700 sets in the seventh year, so A7 is equal to 700. Assuming that production increases uniformly by a fixed number every year, so based upon that assumption we have formed the AP. We have to find the production in first year. So now here is the list of things that we need to find. So we will enlist them over here. What do we need to find? So let us write that. Production in the first year. So production in the first year means first term. So we have to find A, which is the first term, right? Then production in the 10th year, so that is our 10th term, so we want to find A10 also. And apart from that, we have been told to find total production in first 7 years, so that is sum, right? Total production, so that is sum, so we want to find S7. Now in order to find each and every one of these, we need to find the value of A and D. Right, we need to find the value of A and D. So A, though we have to find it, but additionally we also want to find D. Then and then only we can find everything else. Now in order to find all this, we require ultimately A and D, and these are two unknowns. So for that we have been given two unknown equations over here also. So let us work out with those two equations, right? So what we have is A3 is equal to 600. So here let us write A3 means A plus 2D. So A plus 2D is 600. Then we have A7. So A7 is nothing but A plus 6D is equal to 700. Now you can see that the coefficient of A is same, it is 1, and the sign is also same. If the signs are same, then we have to subtract the equation. So we will subtract the equation, right? So let us write over here subtracting the equations. So when we subtract, we have to close the door and we have to change the sign. All are positive, so all will become negative. Now this plus A and minus A will cancel each other. So what we have is 2D minus 6D. So 2 minus 6 is minus 4D over here. Similarly here, 600 minus 700, we get minus 100 over here. So this minus and this minus will cancel each other. So we have D is equal to 100 by 4, or rather we get D is equal to 25. Right, D is equal to 25. Now just put this value D is equal to 25 in any one of the equations. Very sorry, we have not mentioned the equation, so we will mention them as equation number 1 and equation number 2. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Now putting D is equal to 25 in equation number 1, let us do that. Substituting D is equal to 25 in equation number 1. Let us substitute that. So first of all, we will write equation number 1 as it is, a plus 2d is equal to 600, right? Now a will be kept as it is, 2, instead of d we will write 25 is equal to 600. 25 2s are 50. So a plus 50 gives me 600. 50 goes to the other side, it will get subtracted, so we get a is equal to 550. I hope this is clear to you. Now what is a? It is the first term which we need to find. This is our first question, the production in the first year. So we can write therefore production in first year is equal to a is equal to 550 TV sets. So this is the first thing that we need to find. Clear? I hope you don't have any doubt in this. You have to highlight this, right? Because this is one of the things you have to find. Now what we have to find is production in the second year. So this was the first result that we wanted, right? See, be very clear. This is not equation number 1. This is the first result what we wanted. Now let us check for the second result. What we want is production in the 10th year. So we will write over here, production in 10th year is equal to A10. So we know that A10 is nothing but A plus 9D. Now what is the value of A? The value of A is 550 plus 9 multiplied by D. So D is 25. So 9 into 25. Right. So 550 will be kept as it is. 25 into 9 is nothing but 225. So 550 plus 25, 575 plus more 200. So we have 775 as our answer. So this is the production at the end of or in the 10th year. This is not the total. 775 units will be produced in 10th year alone. So this is the second result that we require. Now let us go for the third one. Yes. So what is the third thing that we require is total production in first 7 years. So total production in first 7 years is equal to S7. Very sorry. Is equal to S7. Right. So now let us find S7. See, we know the formula of Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So here we can find S7 is equal to 7 upon 2. Into the brackets we have 2 multiplied by a, so a is 550 plus n minus 1, so n is nothing but 7, so 7 minus 1 into d is 25. Right. Now this S7 will be kept as it is. Here we have 7 upon 2 and here we have 2 into 150, but we will not multiply that. We will keep that as it is. 2 into 550 plus this is 7 minus 1, so 7 minus 1 is 6 multiplied by 25. Right. So again over here 7 upon 2 will be kept as it is. 2 will be taken out common from this both. So here 2 is taken common, so we are left with 550. Here 2 is common, So what we are left with is 3, and 3 multiplied by 25 is 75. Fine, समझो 6 માંથી 2 તો બહાર આવી ગયો તો શું વધ્યું અહીંયા 3 એન્ડ 3 ઇન્ટુ 25 ઇઝ 75 સો નાવ ધીસ 2 એન્ડ ધીસ 2 વિલ કેન્સલ ઈચ અધર સો વોટ વી નાવ હેવ ઇઝ 7 મલ્ટીપ્લાઈડ બાય 550 પ્લસ 75 સો ઇફ આઈ એડ 100 વી ગેટ 650 એન્ડ ધેન આઈ વિલ સબસ્ટ્રેક્ટ 25 સો વી ગેટ 625 સો ધીસ ઇઝ 7 ઇન્ટુ 625 યસ નાવ વી મલ્ટીપ્લાય ધીસ સો we will multiply 600 into 7 right 600 into 7 which will give us 4200 right and more 25 are there so 25 into 7 is simple 175 so when we add them we get 4375 so this both get multiplied and we get 4375 which is nothing but total production at the end of 7 years So this is the third result that we want, total production at the end of 7 years. Right, I hope this is clear to you and you don't have any doubts. Please pause the video and write this down in your CW. Alright, let us now move ahead to exercise 5.3, main question number 3. See, there are 10 sub questions in this. So we will discuss them one by one. Let us start with the first one. Each and everywhere there will be some minor data given to you and you have to find something. So we will not waste time in writing given over here because already we have this much given over here, right? So let us start. Here first term is given to us. Common difference is given to us. Last term is also given to us. And we want to find the value of n and sn. Now one thing is sure. If you want to find sn, you definitely need n. So let us first think about n. How can you get n from the formula of an? Very simple. So let us check the solution over here. Let us first apply the formula of an. So we have been given that the value of an is 50. Now instead of an, we will write a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to 50. What is a? It is 5. Plus n minus 1 will be kept as it is. Instead of d, we will write 3 is equal to 50. Now we can see only n is missing over here. So 50 will go to the other side. So we get n minus 1 into 3 is equal to 45. Because 5 have been subtracted over here. This 3 will go to the division over here. So 45 upon 3 is 15. So we get n minus 1 is equal to 15. Minus 1 will go to the other side. So we get n is equal to 16. So our first target is achieved. We have obtained the value of n, which is nothing but 16. Now let us simplify, find sn. Now sn general form ma nathi puchelu na aya n ni value mane 16 mali gayi che to indirectly we have to find s16 so let us find that right ane last term to aya apeli che an etle 50 to last term bhi tamari e che so we will apply the formula sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus an first term plus last term right Now instead of n we will have 16 because the value of n is 16 so let us apply s16 is equal to 16 upon 2 instead of a we will write 5 it is given to us instead of an which is the last term that is 50 so we will write 50 over here so 16 upon 2 is 8 and 8 will be multiplied by 55 So simply first of all multiply 8 with 50 so we get 400 and 8 with 5 so we get 40 so our answer is 440 so we get s16 is equal to 440 right very simple 8 into 50 is 400 and 8 into 5 is 40 when you add both of them you get 440 this is just for rough work right So here we have our both the answers. Please pause the video and write this down in your CW. All right, I hope you have written them. Let us now move to the next one, second sub question. Yes, so again you can see a few data is given and we have to find D and S13. So let us first of all write solution over here. See, we have been given first term and we have been given A13. Right, હવે આની જગ્યાએ ગમે તે બે ટર્મ આપેલી હશે, અહીંયા ફર્સ્ટ ટર્મ અને 30th ટર્મ આપેલી છે. બાય યુઝિંગ ધીસ બોથ વી કેન ફાઇન્ડ ધ વેલ્યુ ઓફ એ એન્ડ ડી. તો એ તો આપેલો જ છે, ડી આપણે ફાઇન્ડ કરી લઈએ. રાઈટ, તો સૌથી પહેલા ડી ફાઇન્ડ કરી લઈએ, પછી એસ 13 માટેની ચર્ચા કરશું. સો વોટ વી હેવ બીન ગિવન ઇઝ એ 13 ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 35. સો વી કેન રાઇટ ઓવર હિયર એ 13 ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 35. નાવ ઇન્સ્ટેડ ઓફ એ 13 વી કેન રાઇટ A plus 12B, and this 35 will remain as it is. Now instead of A we can write 7 plus 12, D will remain as it is because we need to find it, is equal to 35. I hope this is clear to you, don't have any doubt. We have been given that A13 is 35, A13 is nothing but A plus 12D. Now instead of A we are writing 7, this 7 will go over here and it will get subtracted, so we get 12D is equal to 28, because 35 minus 7 is 28, so we get D is equal to 28 upon 12, D is equal to 28 upon 12. Now this is 4 7s are, this is 4 3s are, so we are left with 7 upon 3. So the value of D is 7 upon 3. So this is our first target that we have achieved. Now we want to find the value of S13. So again S13, at least sum up to 13th term. So 13th term mane apelo chhe. This is the last term actually. So again I can use the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus an. Samajjo aaramthi. તમે બીજી ફોર્મ્યુલા બી યુઝ કરી શકો છો, કોઈ પ્રોબ્લેમ નથી, બટ અહીંયા બધું આપેલું છે, સો વાય ટુ વરી મોર, વી વિલ યુઝ ધીસ ફોર્મ્યુલા ઓનલી. આ એનની જગ્યાએ આપણે 13 લખીએ ખાલી, તો જોઈએ કેવું લાગે છે. S13 ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 13 અપોન 2. આ એની વેલ્યુ બી અત્યારે આપણે નથી મૂકવી, ભલે રાખો, ખાલી એનની વેલ્યુ આપણે મૂકીએ. નાવ યુ કેન સી એ આપેલો છે, યસ, 13 બી આપેલો છે, 35. તો ફર્સ્ટ ટર્મ અને લાસ્ટ ટર્મ બંને આપેલી છે. હા, અહીંયા એસ 15 હોય ને તો આપણે એન બાય 2 ઇન્ટુ 2 પ્લસ એન માઇનસ 1 ઇન્ટુ ડી યુઝ કરીએ, બટ દેટ ઇઝ નોટ ધ કેસ. સો નાવ ધીસ 13 અપોન 2 વિલ રિમેન એઝ ઇટ ઇઝ. ઇન્સ્ટેડ ઓફ એ વી કેન રાઇટ 7, ઇન્સ્ટેડ ઓફ એ 13 વી કેન રાઇટ 35. સો 35 પ્લસ 7 ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ 42. સો 35 પ્લસ 7 ઇઝ 42. Now this 2 will cancel over here how many times? Yes, 21 times. Definitely 21 2s are 42. Now we have to multiply this 13 with 21. So one thing is you can quickly multiply them simply. Another thing is you can multiply 21 with 10. So when you multiply 21 with 10 you get 210, and when you multiply 21 with 3 you get 63. So now when you add them we get 273 as our answer. So you might be quick at doing this. So S13 is 273. I hope this is very much clear to you. Right, please pause the video and write this down in your CW. I hope you have written this. Let us move to the third one. Yes, A12 is equal to 37, D is equal to 3, find A. હવે S12 ને થોડીક વાર માટે ભૂલી જાઓ, ઓલા ક્વેશ્ચન જેવું જ છે, પહેલામાં A આપેલો હતો અને D ફાઇન્ડ કરવાનું હતું. હિયર D ઇઝ ગિવન ટુ અસ એન્ડ વી હેવ ટુ ફાઇન્ડ A. સો અલ્ટિમેટલી વી વિલ સ્ટાર્ટ વિથ ધીસ A12. સો લેટ અસ રાઇટ ધ સોલ્યુશન ઓવર હિયર. A12 ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 37. So instead of A12 we can write A plus 11D is equal to 37. Now A we want to find, so we will keep it as it is, 11 also as it is. Instead of D we will write 3. Now 11 threes are 33. 33 will go to the other side, so it will get subtracted from 37. So we get A is equal to 4. So our first target is achieved. We have found out the value of A. Right. Now we want to find S12. So again here you can see the 12th term is given to you. Matlab last term is given to you and a first term you already have. So again I will apply the formula over here. Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus an. Now instead of n we will write 12. So S12 is equal to 12 upon 2 into a plus a12. Khali n ni value mukeli chhe. You have the value of a, you also have the value of a12. So let us keep this as it is. What is the value of a? It is 4. What is the value of a12? It is 37. So 37 plus 4 is 41. This is an odd number, so you cannot divide it by 2. So we will divide 12 upon 2, which is 6. And 6 will be multiplied by 41. So 6 into 40 is 240. And 6 ones are 6. So we get the answer 246 over here, which is the value of S12. So these are very simple questions which can be asked for 1 mark. એનાથી વધારે પૂછાવાની કોઈ પણ શક્યતાઓ નથી. પ્લીઝ પોઝ ધ વિડીયો એન્ડ રાઇટ ધીસ ડાઉન ઇન યોર CW. ઓલ રાઇટ, આઈ હોપ યુ હેવ રિટન ધીસ. લેટ અસ નાઉ મૂવ ટુ ધ ફોર્થ સમ. જૂનવાણી જમાનામાં પાછા આપણે આવી ગયા છે બ્લેક એન્ડ વ્હાઈટમાં. રાઇટ, અગેન લેટ અસ મૂવ અહેડ. થોડું નવું ચાલુ થાય છે અહીંયાથી. યુ હેવ બીન ગીવન ધ થર્ડ ટર્મ, યુ હેવ બીન ગીવન ધ સમ ઓફ 10 ટર્મ્સ એન્ડ યુ વોન્ટ ટુ ફાઇન્ડ ડી. સમજો આને આરામથી, બહુ જાજુ ટેન્શન લેવા જેવું નથી. રાઈટ, બે સેમ વસ્તુ આપેલી હોય ને, માની લ્યો આ છે A3 આપેલો હોય ને A આપેલો હોય, તો આપણે A3માંથી આપણે યુ હેવ બીન ગીવન ટુ ડિફરન્ટ થિંગ્સ. યુ હેવ બીન ગીવન અ ટર્મ ઓવર હિયર એન્ડ યુ હેવ બીન ગીવન સમ ઓફ ટર્મ્સ ઓવર હિયર. સો વેન એવર સચ ક્વેશ્ચન કમ્સ, વોટ યુ હેવ ટુ ડુ ઇઝ જસ્ટ અપ્લાય ધ ફોર્મ્યુલા ઓફ A3 એન્ડ હિયર અપ્લાય ધ ફોર્મ્યુલા ઓફ S10. સો યુ વિલ ગેટ ટુ ઇક્વેશન્સ. Once you get two equations, you will definitely get the value of A and D. And once you get A and D, you can find anything. Right? So simply apply the formula of A3, apply the formula of S10, solve both the equations, you will get the value of A and D. તો આવું જોજો, આવું પૂછાઈ શકે છે. કોઈ ટર્મ આપેલી હોય અને સમ ઓફ ટર્મ્સ આપેલા હોય. So definitely you will get two equations in such cases. Let us solve this. So A3 is 15, so we shall write here A3 is equal to 15. Now instead of A3 we can write A plus 2D when I apply the formula. So this is our first equation, A plus 2D is equal to 15. Right, I hope this is clear to you. Right, now we will have the formula of S10 over here on the other side. So here I can write S10 is equal to 125. Now what is the formula of Sn? N by 2. So instead of n by 2, here we will write 10 upon 2. Into the brackets 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So n is 10, so 10 minus 1 is 9. So here we can write 9d is equal to 125. Sir, aa na samjhanu bhai. This is the formula, n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Have n ni jagyaye 10 aavi jase. To pachi to aavshe ne, 10 minus 1 is 9, baki badu to same chhe. Right, I hope this is clear to you and you don't have any doubts. Yes. So now take these two over here. So what will happen? We get 250 over here, or take this 10 also over there. So what we are now left with is 2a plus 9b is equal to 125 multiplied by 2 upon 10. See, this is 10 by 2. When it goes to the other side, it becomes 2 by 10. So again, 2a plus 9d will remain as it is. 125 into 2 is what? 250. So 250 upon 10 is 25. So we write over here that 2a plus 9d is 25. So this is our second equation. Fine. Now you can see you have two equations. Definitely you will solve them and obtain the value of a and d. But here the coefficients of a are different. Aya coefficient 1 che, aya coefficient 2 che. So first of all, aa banne ne apde same banava padche. Same banava mate we will multiply equation number 1 by 2. To j aya 2 avse. So let us write over here, multiplying equation number 1 by 2. So when we multiply them, we get 2a. Instead of a, we will get 2a. 2 2s are 4b. And 15 2s are 30. So we have multiplied them by 2. Everything is double. 2a, 2 2s are 4d, 15 2s are 30. And this equation, we will write over here as it is. So here we have 2a plus 9d is equal to 25. Now you can see the coefficients are same, but the signs are also same. So we need to subtract the equations. So we will write over here, subtracting the equation. So when we subtract, we have to change the sign. We have changed them. So 2a and minus 2a will cancel each other. Now 4d minus 9d. So 4 minus 9 is minus 5. So we can write over here minus 5d. And 30 minus 25 is nothing but 5. So 30 minus 25 is 5, right? Clear? Now this minus 5 will go to the other side, so we get 5 upon minus 5, and when I cancel them, I get d is equal to minus 1. So somewhere your first target is achieved. You have obtained the value of d, which we have to find over here, that is minus 1. So bahut simple che, bhale bhi alag alag vastu aapeli che, but you will get two different equations, and when you solve, you get d mali gayi, pachi a to mali j jashe. So substituting d is equal to minus 1 in equation number 1. Voti j levano, kidhu hoy ke na kidhu hoy, right? So let us write over here, substituting d is equal to minus 1 in equation number 1. So for doing that, we will have to write equation number 1 once again. So that is a plus 2d is equal to 15. Now here a will be kept as it is, plus 2. Instead of d, we will write minus 1. So 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. So a minus 2 is 15. So minus 2 goes to the other side. It will get added, so we get a is equal to 17, right? So now we want to find A10, we will find it over here. So we get A10 is equal to A plus 9D. Right, now A will be kept as 17 plus 9 as it is. Instead of D, we will write minus 1. So this is 17 minus 9, because plus minus minus, 9 ones are 9. 17 minus 10 is 7, you add 1, so you get 8. So we get A10 is equal to 8. So now you have found out both the things that you want to find. Very easy sum. Please pause the video and write this down in your CW. Alright, I hope you have written this. Let us now move to the next sum. Yes, fifth one. So here D and S9 are given to you. Just apply the formula of S9. Automatically, we will get what we want. So let us check the solution over here. We will apply the formula of Sn. So Sn is n upon 2. 2a plus n minus 1 into D. Instead of n, we will write 9 over here. So that will be 9 upon 2. 2 will be kept as it is. A we want to find. Again, n will be 9, right? So 9 minus 1. And instead of D, we will write 5. Clear? Simply applied the formula and put up the values. Now, 9 upon 2 will be kept as it is. 2a will be kept as it is because we want to find the value of a. 9 minus 1 is 8. 8 5s are 40. So you can see there is 2 common over here, and instead of S9 you can write 75 over here, right? So either take 2 common or multiply this 2 over here, but it is better to take 2 common over here. So when we take 2 common, we are left with A plus 20 over here. So this 2 and this 2 will cancel each other, right? So now what we have is 75 is equal to 9 into A plus 20. 9 will go to the division over here. So 75 upon 9 is equal to A plus 20. So you can see these both are divisible by 3. So 3 3s are 325s are, right? So what we now have is, we can write over here, 25 upon 3. Sorry, let us write it over here. Yes, 25 upon 3 is equal to A plus 20. So 20 will go to the other side, right? So what we now have is 25 upon 3 minus 20 is equal to A. I hope this is clear to you. Take the LCM or cross multiplication. 3 into minus 20 is minus 60. So we get 25 minus 60 upon 3 is equal to A. 60 minus 20 is 40, minus 5 is 35. So we get minus 35 upon 3 as our answer. So now we will find the value of A9, right? So let us find that. Yes. So A9, right? Let us change the colors so that we have some clarification over here. So A9 is equal to A plus 8 times D. What is the value of A? Minus 35 upon 3 plus 8 into what is the value of D? It is 5. So 8 5s are 40. So 40 we will write ahead, and minus 35 upon 3 we will write over here behind. So 3 into 40 is 120. So we have 120 minus 35 whole divided by 3. 120 minus 30 is 90. 90 minus 5 is 85. So we have 85 upon 3 as our answer for the ninth term, right? So this is first term and this is ninth term. Very simple. So whatever you are given, just apply the formulas in those both and you will get the subsequent answers. That's it, right? So we end up our video lecture over here. In the next video lecture, we will continue further from sub question 6. and we will move ahead in the chapter. Just write this in the CW. Don't write anything else. Just write this in the CW. Fine. Thank you very much for watching. We will now meet again in the next video lecture. Till then, take very good care of yourselves. Goodbye.